So it's giving us a choice of where we want to go. Interesting. I actually didn't know it did that. Oh, forgotten passage. Okay. Fragmented passage on old Arcovia's history. Impossible to decipher without the remaining pieces. Okay, so there's three pieces of that to piece together. Piece, piece, piece. Now for war. Oh goodness, that's a lot of damage all of a sudden. Not quite all of them. I need to pick up more loot so I can see my foes. There we go. Oh, Chaos Gaze. I remember seeing that in a previous playthrough. Sounds like there's a choice, but there's only one route because to repair the bridge, you still need to go through the Deadman's. Right, okay. I getcha. Thanks for bringing that to my attention. You know what they say. Information is ammunition. Oh, and I dinged in all that, yes. Reached the despised level. Wait, who despises me now? Oh, the Arcovian undead. Okay. What a shame. Okay, that's weird. Look at those shadows move as I walk. Makes me think that the original design was lost somewhere. Yeah, I mean, possibly. But maybe that was the intent, just to make it seem like there was a second route, or maybe we get to open it up. Who knows? I mean, admittedly, I didn't follow the development of this game, so I really don't know a lot about that aspect of the game. Anyway. Greetings, you do not know me, but I've heard of you. I'm Belvaruk of the Order of Death's Vigil. Your exploits lead me to believe that you may just be who I need for my assignment. Assignment? Yes, I'm here to purge the land of several malevolent spirits. Their tainted presence has corrupted Arcovia long enough. However, my masters have underestimated the degree to which the ancient oligarchs have surrounded themselves with their former subjects. The Arcovian Undercity is swarming with the dead. I fear, I admit, far more than I could handle without the aid of my brothers. But you... you are quickly proving to be a force of reckoning in this world, as this world has never seen. Cool. Travel down into the Undercity and banish the spirits of Nomos Dread, Laudus Vagra, and Ravina Kerr. When you're finished, seek out my companion, Goldoros, at the entrance of the Steps of Torment. He'll guide you to your final target. Okay. Fine. I don't mind. Right. Okay. And if it means more violence... a little bit of a concern. What effect is causing the enemies to run away? Is it only the undead and they're being affected by Targo's hammer? I guess I'll have to look into that at some point. But yeah, enemies running away is not very good for retaliation builds. We need the enemies to come to us so that they throw themselves upon our, spikes. No good me just hitting them with my weapon. There's another shrine there I just noticed, but definitely need to unload my gear again.
See what's left of my wares.
Not bad leg plates. But, again, no retaliation damage. Rare component. Chaos gaze. I'll keep hold of that. But that's not for me. I guess I should probably level up as well.
Got something you need stashed?
Okay, let's have a look. Now, what could I level up? There we go. Get Counter-Strike at level 19 of 16. I believe it's the petition set that gives that's giving me some extra points in Counter-Strike. Wrong. Oh no, it's this plate mail of thorns that's giving me +3 levels to Counter-Strike. Okay, well, now I know. Have a look, see what we've got available. Get another point into Warcry. Warcry is quite nice. The larger the radius as well, the more this catches ranged enemies. And I have noticed that sometimes The ranged enemies will drop their ranged attack to come into a hit with a melee weapon if I hit them with a war cry, but it doesn't seem to always happen, so I don't know what the mechanics are at play there. Anything in Oathkeeper? What to do? Tempting to get Haven for the healing effects increase, but that doesn't change health regeneration. But okay, I would need at least one point so that I could get a point in Rebuke, which does, yeah, retaliation damage. There we go. Put a point into the Oathkeeper just so we can get closer to Rebuke. Alright, back we go. Lots of back and forth right now. It's not my fault they keep dropping all this loot. In fact, I'm going to untick that. I'll keep the shield. One-handed melees. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I guess we'll have to just put up with it. Right. Shrine. This shrine is corrupted and needs to be cleansed. Summon what is trapped within? Yes. Hello. It's a bunch of people who should have stayed dead. Okay. And here comes the loot. Come on. There we go. Now we've got another devotion point. Chest guard of perdition. There we go, there's the full set. I'll lose 3 points of Counter-Strike, which is a bit of a shame, but all that retaliation damage, I think, makes up for it. Beautiful. Right, okay, well, now I can no longer use this sword. For whatever reason. Oh, I need more cunning to use it. Okay. Guess we're going to be using a mace again for a while. Well. Back we go again.
See anything you like.
Right, I know that's a component. I'm gonna keep this plate mail of thorns. Because it's a pretty nice piece of armor. Even if I don't use it for myself. Another character of mine may want it. sword as well is quite attractive. So keep hold of that as well.
Safe storage, no questions asked.
Let's put them anywhere for now. Oops. Yeah, I
let's see what I can do.
I could make myself look a little ridiculous if I feel like it, but don't particularly feel like it. Devotions. Okay, so we've now completed Anvil. Where do we go from here? There are options. Hound is a possibility. Plus 40% to all retaliation damage as the first point of that. Oh, sorry, no, that is the last point in that, so... Yeah, this is the bit that puts me off putting points into Hound. 15 physique, not bad, but then... Plus 8% health to pets. Good for pet builds, but I'm not doing a pet build. Then there's 30% extra retaliation damage. Quite appealing. And then 40%. Are there any other options? Seem to remember one that I was looking for. A while ago, when I was first theory crafting this character. I can't seem to find them on the map. Well, the constellation map, that is. Which is a little bit frustrating. So, yeah, searching for retaliation, highlighting a bunch of things here. Wraith, Wraith is definitely one to consider. Getting lightning retaliation, you know, diversifying my damage types is certainly going to help with a solo build. If I wanted Targo, I need to put points into the yellow affinity. That's yet another crossroads I need to put points into. Meanwhile, Rat. Acid retaliation, which I've got with the petition set. Again, needing to dip into another crossroads. The Messenger of War. I remember seeing this and thinking, that looks pretty good, but it's quite far away. Stone Matron, was she the one I was looking at previously? Quite possibly, but that's clearly a late game constellation to dip into. Okay, I think I should invest into Wraith here. It'll get me some more points in purple and blue constellation affinity, which means it brings me even closer to the Stone Matron. Not quite sure how else I could build towards that, though. Especially considering... The Messenger of War doesn't actually require me to have points in red affinity. So that is also a possibility. I mean, there's a lot of stars in this constellation that will help out retaliation, so... Yeah, okay, we'll put points into Wraith. There we go. And, soon I'll have ether resistance as well, which is always nice. Okay. There you go. A little bit of theory crafting with Mookie. Done it on stream for once, rather than done it off stream like I normally do. Okay, right, back into the fray, I guess. Howdy! How you doing? If you're doing well... Ooh, devotion level. Torvo's hammer. What was that messenger? Missed that. Oh, right. Okay, so yeah. Targo's hammer is leveling up. Right, okay. With you now. Come on. Time to send you guys back to bed. Forever sleep. Okay. Oh. Down we go. Oh. Okay. Try that again. Now we go inside.